I'm hungry. What about you? A short story by John Glover. Robert frequently returned to the Crowne Plaza. On one occasion, he noticed that two adults were complaining about being asked to leave the kitchen tent. It appeared they wanted food. The Krakow policy was intended to separate local residents from Ukrainian refugees. The young volunteer had told him this. It might be understood the policy was a necessary one because there were international rules with strings attached for the continuation of aid. Hopefully, Krakow residents had other resources. Yet, Robert felt that if someone needed food, it should be given to him. After Robert returned to Fishermen, one morning while riding the bus to work, he observed a billboard overhead that read, "Food is a human right." He stared at the words. He was startled. He thought, "Does anyone know what that means?" He grabbed his camera and took a photo for his reference. Surely the hungry Krakow residents would think it unfair that Ukrainians could find food, but they could not. It would be difficult for the residents to understand why the policy prevented their access to food. When someone needs food, they often need it immediately, especially the poor and hungry. Unfortunately, now the poor and hungry of Krakow might view Ukrainians in a rather poor light when Ukrainians can get food and beverage, but they cannot. Prejudice might be aimed at the refugees by have-nots of the Poles, and maybe others. The man wasn't about to enter the fray to learn more about the disagreement, much less to resolve it. In hindsight, his quicker hand might have been to extend out to theirs some zlotys. Upon returning from Kyiv to Krakow later in June, Robert visited the Starbucks located on the outer rim of the Crown Plaza. Starbucks is a chain of coffee cafes. He really needed a nice tasting cup of coffee. He'd see if Krakow Starbucks could satisfy him. The sun was bright. The sky was blue without a cloud in the sky, and it was a warm day. There were amazing flower beds of bright yellow and golden chrysanthemums, which attracted most everyone's attention. The Starbucks store space was small. Its front doors were maybe 40 yards from the refugee tents. It had a nice patio, which was on the other side of the store and away from the tents. On this day, Robert was approached by a 40-year-old man. The man had walked over the grassy knoll to the patio where Robert now sat under an umbrella. The landscape was designed to separate the patio from the public corridor that went to the Crown Plaza. Clearly, the man had earlier spotted Robert because once Robert walked out the doors to the patio, the stranger made a beeline over to him across the hill. The stranger said something in a language Robert did not understand. It was unclear whether it was Polish or what it was, but it wasn't Ukrainian since martial law stopped their men from crossing into Poland or any other country. He might have been Romani. Clearly, the man was asking for money. Robert decided to drill into him about not using the money for alcohol or drugs, but only for food and shelter. Robert spoke loudly at him. "No alcohol. Do not buy alcohol. No drugs. Do you understand what I am saying? Buy food, no drugs. Do you speak Polish? Do you understand English? No alcohol, no drugs. No give you money if buy alcohol. No drugs. Buy food or housing. It went on like this for a straight minute. The stranger never replied, but stayed still, silent, with a stern face. He knew, so long as Robert talked, he was winning. Eventually, after enough awkwardness and making a scene, Robert coughed up 200 zlotys, which was about 45 USD. After all of that, no thanks needed. Robert did not want one. He took the money, turned, and without a word, the man walked away. Even before Robert's hand reached over with the money, he realized another sizable gift was not going to Ukraine refugees. This bothered him. During the loud and awkwardness, the very beautiful young women and men sitting at tables nearby did not intervene, interrupt, or interpret what the man was saying. Nor did they show anger or anything. It was as though Robert did not exist, nor the stranger. The end.